extremely rich people who have absolutely nothing wrong with them.
Hello. I'd like to talk to you tonight about a minority group of people who have no mental or physical handicaps and who, through no fault of their own, have never been deprived and consequently are forced to live in conditions of extreme luxury. This often ignored minority is very rarely brought to the attention of the general public. The average man in the street scarcely gives a second thought to these extremely well-off people. He quite simply fails to appreciate the pressures that vast quantities of money just do not bring. Have you at home ever had to cope with this problem? Or this? I know it's only human to say, oh, this will never happen to me. And of course, it won't.
So I'm asking you, please, please, send no contributions, however large, to me.
There now follows a party
All
political
right,
broadcast
go.
On behalf of the Liberal Party.
Hello, madam.
Oh, hello. You must have come about...
Finishing the sentences, yes.
Oh, well, perhaps you'd like to...
Come through this way, certainly. Oh, nice place you've got here. Oh,
yes, well, we...
Like it?
Yes, we certainly...
Do, good. Now, when did you first start...
Finding it difficult to...
To finish sentences, yes.
Well, it's not me, it's my...
Husband?
Yes, he...
Never lets you finish what you've started.
Quite, I'm beginning to feel...
You'll never finish a sentence again as long as you live.
Exactly.
Lee, it must be awesome.
It's driving me...
To drink?
No,
rum. And the bend? Mm. Duh.
Yes.
May I,
take a seat.
Thank you. You see, our method is to reassure the patient by recreating normal...
Conditions.
Yes. Then we try and get them into a position where they suddenly find that they're completing other people's sentences...
themselves.
Spot on, Mrs.
Smith.
Good. Well, try not to overdo it to...
Begin with.
Good. Just keep it to one or two...
Words.
...to start off with. Otherwise, you may find that
I'm
you're...
I'm taking on too long a sentence and getting completely,
stuck. Good. Yes, well, that's about it.
For now, so...
Thanks very much for calling.
Oh, not at all.
And,
just like to say...
Thank you very much for coming along.
Not at all.
And good...
Bye, Mr...
Vernon. Yes, dear? Oh, no. How many's that now?
12 since lunch. Oh, there's another one.
Is Stonehenge, and it's from here we go to Africa.
Well, here it is at last, the goal of our quest. After 6 months and 3 days, we finally caught up with the legendary walking tree of Dahomey, Quercus Nicolas Parsonus, resting here for a moment on its long journey south. It's almost incredible, isn't it, to think that this huge tree has walked over 2,000 miles across this inhospitable terrain to stop here, maybe just to take in water before the 2,000 miles on to Cape Town where it lives. It's almost unimaginable, I find, the thought of this mighty tree strolling through Nigeria, perhaps swaggering a little as it crosses the border into Zaire, hopping through the tropical rainforest, trying to find a quiet grove where it can jump around on its own, sprinting up to Zambia for the afternoon, then nipping back to... Oh, super. Well, I've just been told that this is not in fact, the legendary walking tree of Dahomey. This is one of Africa's many stationary trees, Arborus bamba gascoinus. In fact, we've just missed the walking tree. It left here at 8 o'clock this morning. It was heading off in that direction, so we'll just see if we can go and catch it up. Come on, boys. Well, we're still keeping up with it, but it's setting a furious pace. Early this morning, we thought we'd spotted it, but it turned out to be an Angolan sauntering tree, Amazellus robin rayi, out walking with a Gambian sidling bush. So, on we go. It's going to be difficult. The walking tree can achieve speeds of up to 50 miles an hour, especially when it's in a hurry. But... super. Well, Rupert has spotted something. This could be...